Good day, everyone. So this will be our first discussion, the first topic in our subject, Foundations of Special and Inclusive Education. So again, I am Ms. Rhea Jane, your teacher for this subject. In today's discussion, you will obtain a better understanding of what diversity is. So using Lawden's Wheel of Diversity, the various aspects that make one person different from the other will enable you to discuss how each aspect contributes to each one's identity, beliefs, practices, and behavior. So you will also gain an understanding of why it is important to recognize disability as part of diversity. So you will learn about how diversity as a positive component contributes to progress and productivity. So it is important that we recognize and accept diversity. So this means accepting, respecting, and tolerating each other's differences. So it means awareness of laws, policies, and systems that uphold one's individuality and uniqueness. So this would mean a more peaceful and humane world. So if a group of people were asked to list down their characteristics and compare them, the chances of having a good number with exactly the same characteristics will be zero. So even twins will have different personalities and characteristics, and there are many factors that make one person different from the other. So these are marked differences that are visible. So there are physical characteristics like the color skin, the color of the hair, the shape of the eyes, the nose, the height, what else? The weight, the gender, the age, and the socioeconomic class, and also the occupation, and many others. So these characteristics are quite obvious and noticeable. As you walk through a mall, you will easily notice the differences of the people you meet. So there are other differences brought about by one's beliefs, mindsets, values, sexual identity, and intelligence, and the personality, and others that are not easily evident or invisible. So these characteristics are not seen but are manifested through behavior, decisions, and word spoken. So you will need to get to know a person closer to be able to observe that he she is different from you or other people. So the visible and invisible characteristics of diversity are not necessarily connected, because there are times when a visible characteristics like skin color will easily be related to a disposition or trait. So for example, people from Africa who have a dark skin color are believed to be poor and unschooled. So this is not necessarily true, but biases play a role in these assumptions. So it is the uniqueness of each one that is the root of diversity. So the English noun that captures the essence of difference is what we call the diversity. So the diversity comes from the Latin word divertire, which means to turn away, separate, and oppose, from the Latin dictionary. While according to Collins' dictionary, diversity means the state or quality of being different or varied, a variety or assortment, a point of difference, the inclusion of people of different races, genders, religions, and etc. in a group. So, the relation that holds between two entities when and only when they are not identical. So the property of being numerically distinct. So in the United Nations Educational, Scientific, and Cultural Organizations, or the UNESCO, Guide on Ensuring Inclusion and Equity in Education, they identify or they defined diversity as people's differences which may relate to their race, ethnicity, gender, sexual orientation, language, culture, religion, mental and physical ability, the class, and the immigration status. So the diversity is an issue we have to face and conquer. So presently, people recognize and consider the differences of each person as important. So we all live in a global village that brings about changing demographic both in the workforce and in the education. So as our communities become more diverse, it is imperative that we make an effort to understand the different dimensions of diversity, which is not just all about accepting, understanding, and tolerating one's uniqueness or differences. So confronted with the need to live in one global village, it is a valuable that we discover and explore areas that could connect us and allow us to do the collaborative works. So accepting and celebrating the uniqueness of each individual will allow for respecting different experiences and qualities of individuals that will open up more avenues to experiences, to solve problems and innovate. So the collaboration and communication are skills that are needed to develop and succeed. So it is therefore important that we understand our differences and master how this could be used to harness tolerance, cooperation, and unity that will lead to productivity. So let us now proceed to the Loden's diversity wheel. So in 1990, Marilyn Loden, an American writer, and Judy Rosner, a professor at the graduate school in the University of California. So Irvine developed a framework to respond to flourishing divergence in Americans' labor force. So their goal was to capacitate people to make their voices heard by pointing to their diversity and its impact on their person, so their rights and their freedom. So Loden and Rosner published the book Workforce America, Managing Employee Diversity as a Vital Resource. So in this book, the original version of the diversity wheel model was introduced. So Loden recognized the demand for an instrument that would help people better understand how group-based differences influence people's social identities. So the dissatisfaction, the distrust, and competition would ensue when the different dimensions of diversity are not given recognition. So Loden and Rosner's extensive research led them to maximizing the workforce of a diverse group of people, managing diversity as assets to develop productive working relationships. So the model was revised in 1996 to cover additional aspects of group differences that were implied in the first model. So the changes were to recognize the experiences of people who identify these aspects as most important to their personhood. So the different components in the diversity wheel played a significant role in building character and possibly forming stereotypes. So she hoped that this could be used to further discuss diversities, not only in the workforce, but globally. So in her book, Loden states, "I think diversity discussions are really about understanding our social identities, acknowledging what is important, and learning to integrate into society so that no subgroup feels excluded or one down." So the Loden and Rosner's diversity wheel, so I have here a figure for us to understand better the Loden and Rosner's diversity wheel. So in here, it pointed to the significance of our social characters. So and the ways in which people develop their identity when they are able to establish a connection with a specific group of people. So the wheel consists of a primary or core and secondary dimensions of diversity. So the categories put forward the effect of these differences on a person's beliefs, expectations, what else, and life experiences. So the dimensions are the components that comprise the whole person. So the primary or the core dimensions are in the inner circle. So again, this is the primary and the core dimensions. So these are the stronger ones. So these are the characteristics we were born or established by significant experiences we had or people we interacted with. So these are the considered to be distinctly persuasive in establishing who we are, our principles, our sense of self, our image, our perceptions, and how we think about others. So these core dimensions or attributes are in place or established and are the least likely to change. So these core elements are age, the ethnicity, the gender, what else, the physical abilities, qualities, the race, the income, the sexual orientation, the class, and the spiritual beliefs. So we have also the secondary dimensions, which is the outer circle. So these characteristics are also part of our social identity. So, but they can change or be discarded as our life experiences impact us. So just like, unlike the inner core, the outer core or the outer circle or the secondary dimensions, they are influenced by people we encounter. So places we go to live in and experience we go through. So the second dimension is composed of geographical location, the marital status, the religious beliefs, the parental status, the income, the education, the work experience, the military experience, first language, the family status, and the work and communication style. So work experience and communication style. So this is the Lodden and Rosner's diversity wheel. Another dimension of diversity that is significant is the dimension of the ability and disability. So the diversity covers the limitless domains of an individual's unique characteristics, experience, and capabilities. So diversity encompasses respect and tolerance of difference that enables a celebration of uniqueness. So according to Collins English Dictionary, ability refers to the possession of the qualities required to do something. So necessary skill or competence or power. So on the other hand, disability is defined by the World Health Organization or the WHO as the umbrella term for impairments, activity limitations, and participation restrictions. So this refers to the negative aspects of the interaction between an individual with a health condition and that individual's contextual factors, which is the environmental and the personal factors. So this definition underscores that disability is not only a health issue, but also an issue that affects a person's states in life and the environment he, she is in. So a person's self-identity and his or her perspectives of the world around him or her are affected by both ability and disability. So the ADA or the American Disabilities Act of 1990 defines a person with a disability as a person who has a physical or mental impairment that substantially limits one or more major life activity. So this includes people who have record of such impairment even if they do not currently have disability. So it also includes individuals who do not have a disability but are regarded as having a disability. So disability or disabilities may affect one's senses or one's mobility. They may be static or progressive, congenital or acquired, formal or affecting the shape of the body, or functional, visible or invisible. So, a person's disability makes him her a unique individual who is at times shunned from places and activities. So, they have to be acknowledged as part of this spectrum of diversity. So, they have to be recognized as human beings who should not be discriminated against, but rather understood, accepted, and tolerated. So, they have to be accorded their rights. And disabilities have to be seen as natural part of life and a natural part of diversity. So people with disabilities have to be perceived and accepted as people with distinct abilities. So they have to identify themselves as having disabilities so that the world can accept them and create avenues for them to live in. So in this age of fast-paced development, where diversity plays a unique role, there are still challenges that confront a lot of people who have been identified as different. So that is the discrimination issues around race, gender, age, and intellect still abound in spite of charters, the laws, and policies that uphold diversity. So in some workplaces, women and people of color are still discriminated against and not given position in management or administration. So people of a certain race are stereotyped to be a specific character. So a number of times, Muslims have been taken aside in immigration and interrogated. So, non-married and sex couples are still not accepted in some parts of the world. So, in some schools, children with special needs are shunned with the reason that they are not ready for school yet or are not suited for the school. So, children from indigenous groups have to go through an educational system that does not consider their ethnic background, the needs, and the values. So though there is still so much effort that needs to be put in so that diversity is accepted, respected, and tolerated, there has been progress in a lot of areas. So in more workplaces, there are systems and processes put into place to intentionally promote diversity. So the diverse ways of thinking and doing things bring in creativity and productivity. So innovative thinking and collaboration are encouraged when different people work to come up with solutions to problems or challenges. So in schools, diversity is the best way to teach what it means to be tolerant and respectful of each other's differences. So in government, the acknowledgement that diversity is an integral component of community equates to laws and policies being passed to look out for the welfare of people of diverse cultures and backgrounds. So diversity, therefore, is an integral component of life and of living. So that's all for today's discussion about the diversity and understanding the diversity. So if you have any questions or misunderstanding regarding to our discussion today, you can just chat it in our group, official group chat, and I will answer and accommodate you to that. So make sure to finish the video because I included here the performance activity. So thank you very much and have a nice day, everyone. So for your performance activity, answer the following questions. So this is consist of 60 points. So put your answer in the comment section below by following the format. So you have to include your name first, the block or the cluster you are in, and your answer. So the deadline of submission is on August 11, 2023, 8 o'clock p.m. only. So again, don't forget to write your name, your block or your cluster, and your answer. So for the first question, read each paragraph and explain what you would do and why. A parent asks to see you. He demands that you take out the crucifix inside your classroom because the religion they belong to does not believe in the crucifix. He insists that his child is being taught the wrong values. How will you respond to that parent? Second question. You plan a relay game for your class. While you are explaining the mechanics of the game, one student raises her hand and says she can't do a particular task in the game because she has a prosthetic leg. How will you respond to this situation? For the third question, during a class election, Gina and Roy are running for the position of class president. What criteria will you base your decision on whom to vote for?